Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I am going to show you how to install IntelliJ IDEA IDE in Windows 10 operating system. So, let's begin. Now, before installing IntelliJ IDEA, let us first understand why to use IntelliJ IDEA IDE. Now, if you are a Java developer or if you want to be a Java developer, then IntelliJ IDEA IDE is a very good IDE. So, let us see how we can download this IntelliJ IDEA. So, for that, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in here, just you need to simply type IntelliJ IDEA download. Then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com is basically our first search result. So now just simply click on this download IntelliJ IDEA. And this will automatically going to redirect you to this official site of JetBrains. You can clearly see this official site of JetBrains loaded over here. Here, if you just scroll down a bit and for the time being, let us first cancel these cookies and all, you'll be getting these two options. One is Ultimate, another is Community one. And we are downloading for Windows. If you want to install it for Mac OS or Linux, then you need to just simply proceed with these links and you can easily download by clicking on that download button. But in this video I'm going to show you how to download IntelliJ IDEA for Windows operating system, and we are going to install this community version, which is basically a free one and open source. So to install, just simply first click on this download button. And you can clearly see it's telling that thank you for downloading IntelliJ IDEA. It has rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, that is this version 2021.1.3, has been rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, just simply double click on it. And let us first minimize our download directory, and then you need to click on yes to provide administrative privileges, and then you'll be seeing this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition Setup Installation Wizard. So just simply click on next, and this will automatically going to redirect you to this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition Setup. Choose install location. So this is basically your installation destination. So if you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on browse button and you can change that. And you can clearly see you need to have 1.6 GB of free space in your C directory. This is very important because you are going to save in the C directory, right? So in the C directory, you need to have at least 1.6 GB of free space. Currently, I am having 224.6 GB of free space. So I have sufficient amount of space. So do check that and then just simply click on next. And then you'll be seeing under these installation options, some options. So we are basically going to check the 64-bit launcher because this is a 64-bit operating system. So we would also like to create this desktop shortcut. So for that, just simply going to check 64-bit launcher. And then we'd also like to check this add launcher directory to path. And it's telling that restart needed. So we are going to restart as well. And here it's telling that you can also restart later. That's not a big problem. Alright, and we are also going to check this add folder as a project so that we can automatically going to import our entire folder as a project. Alright, and we are basically going to use this IntelliJ IDEA for Java developers. So that's why we are checking this Java. If you want to use this Groovy or Kotlin, say then you need to simply proceed with these links as well. I am going to use for Java developers, so that's why I just want to simply going to check for .java and then just simply click on next. And now it's telling that they're going to create this JetBrains folder. So just simply keep all this default and then just simply click on install for installation. And this will automatically going to start installing your IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. You can always click on the show details and you can see how the installation is actually happening. It will take some time, maybe a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition Setup. Yeah. So we'll come back And now as you can clearly see, our IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup has been actually completed, and it's now currently telling that whether we want to reboot now or we want to reboot later. So as I have mentioned, you can always reboot later. That will not create any big issue. So just simply click on I want to manually reboot later, which is basically our default option, and then just simply click on finish. And then you'll be seeing this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition 2021.1.3 desktop shortcut has also been created over here. So just simply double click on it to open this software. And you can clearly see our JetBrains Community Edition has been rightly open, and it's now kind of telling that when it confirm this license terms and agreement. So you just need to simply check that and then just simply click on continue. And then it's telling that whether we'd like to share our data. So for the time being, I don't want to send. So just simply click on don't send, and you can clearly see our IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition 2021.1 has been rightly launched, and it's now currently telling that welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. So let us first maximize it, and in here I'll be showing you how to create a new project. So for that, you need to just click on new project over here, and this is automatically going to open this new project. And in this SDK section, you can clearly see that it's now currently telling that no SDK. That is because I have not Java installed on my machine. So for that, you can always download your Java by just simply clicking on this download JDK. And this is going to download the latest version of Java, that is 16, going to download over here. So just simply click on download, and this will going to start downloading your latest version of Java. If you have previously installed Java following my video, that I will be also putting the link in the description, or you will be also getting in the I button. So if you have previously installed Java, then you will not be getting this option, because in my machine right now I don't have Java installed. So that's why I need to download Java manually by this process. If you have not installed Java previously, then you need to do the same process that I am doing currently. And so for that, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation, because the Java is actually going to download and it's now going to install. So for that, you need to have active internet connection, right? So now you can clearly see our Java has been almost rightly downloaded, and it's now currently installing this Oracle OpenJDK. You can clearly see, and the version is 16.0.1. So that is basically the latest version. Thank you. few seconds you'll going to see the output in our console. Right now it's downloading some other packages, so it might take some time if you are doing for the first time. So now, as you can clearly see, our hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our console, right? So in this way, you install IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. I have shown you how to install the latest version, and then I have also shown you how to create a simple hello world project and how to print them. So that's basically all about this video. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do also check our website geekyscript.com. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do share with your friends and do press the subscribe button. So that's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and God bless you all.